All right, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It's Mr. Amos Kester. We're back here in Bayelsa State. This is the fish farm where we showed you the video when we were still doing the construction. The excavator was still here at that time. So you can see from this angle, from the view on this side, you can see that we are done with all the ponds, and also we have covered them with the nets. Now, the reason why we cover them with the nets is to avoid bird predation, because we live in a very forested area. We have some bushes around, even though the site of the farm seems to be in town. But due to the environment we find ourselves, we usually have a prevalence of bird predation. So in order for us to maintain the management practices, we need to ensure that the ponds are covered at this point so that birds don't pick out your fishes. So sometimes you may have a fish farm and probably you stocked 10,000 snails when you harvest, sorry, 10,000 fishes. And when you harvest, you find out that you just have about 4,000 or 3,000. And that might lead you to start suspecting your farm attendants or those working for you. But that is not always the case. If you don't have a net covering for your fish pond like we have here, you have issues of bird predation. Now, if you come closer, you will see what we just discovered here. So, you can see this guy is the first victim of the nets here. We've been having some issues. At first, we didn't have this net by this side, so we had some openings on this front part. So if you look at it, you see adjoinment of this net. This to tell you this is a new one. So we discovered, despite covering the top, these guys will still go in. They will patch and go in and do their damage, then come out and fly off. So we had to screen the corners too with the net, and we just came back and discovered that this one is here. So these are some of the dangers you must watch out for in pond construction or fish farming generally. So we are going to walk you through down to that side, but this is the afternoon. What we have here are juveniles, and usually we feed them 3 times during the day. In the morning between the hours of 8, in the afternoon between the hours of 1, and in the evening between the hours of 5 to 6. So usually when they are this young, at the juvenile stage, you have to feed them 3 times. It is when they have left this stage, gotten to the jungles and growing into average sizes, you begin to feed 2 times a day in order to manage the feed. So this is how you spread the feed, and you make sure you always feed in one particular spot. You cannot feed here, go there and feed, and go there and pour feed. If you do that, most of your fishes will not be feeding properly, because there's no specific place where they will all come for feeding. So usually when you start the feeding, you start with one location. So you continue feeding there, even if the fishes don't seem to come at some point, or you just keep feeding there, it will get to a point where all the fishes will come to understand that this is the only place where feed comes from. So at the point where they've come to that understanding, immediately you get to this point of the pond. All the fishes from every other area of the pond will just come here and wait for you in order for you to feed them. So that is what is happening. And also, for you not to waste your feed, you have to wait. After you spray the feed like this, you have to wait to ensure that the fishes are consuming the feed, because it may get to a point where they don't take it anymore and you'll be wasting the feed. The feed will be floating on top of the water, and also it may result to water pollution, because the feed that is not consumed by the fishes will pollute the water. So because of that, you have to wait, you have to be patient, because this is all you are expected to do as a fish farm attendant. You give them, as you can see now, they are done with what I just gave them. So I have to put another one again and observe them again to see how well they take that. So at the point where you notice that they are getting to full and the feed is beginning to float and they are not picking it that much again, you have to stop giving them the feed. And if possible, you get a scoop net and scoop out the leftover feed that is floating on the surface of the water, because if you don't scoop it out, it will eventually sink to the base of the water and contribute to water pollution, which is not good for the health of the fishes. So with this, I think we're done at this point here. So the fishes are no longer picking the feed, and they just have a few down there. So I believe sooner or later they'll pick those ones, and that will be it. So we'll just walk you through the ponds. We have 6 ponds here, 4 ponds measuring equal size, and I think we have 5 ponds here, 4 measuring equal size and 1 very big one that is measuring almost double the other 4. Alright, so that's what we have. We just wanted to walk you through and show you how the ponds have been covered and how you need to follow these procedures. Now, this environment is actually very, very waterlogged, and the soil here is very slippery. So that is why, if you look at it now, you will see that we use some woods to hold the dike. Initially, we didn't do this because the soil or the mud was slippery in trying to prepare the dikes. So it keeps sliding back. This is a very waterlogged environment, so soil in such environments are very loose, and also the clay property is high, but also mixed with a lot of water, so it keeps slanting back into the pond. So that is why we're back to putting this, and we have to load it up to protect it from sliding. So probably after a few weeks, this will be taken out and the soil will remain because it has gained solidity here. So that is why you're seeing it actually, because of the topography and the soil texture, the ponds have not been prepared to the tastes that we would like them to be. So after the first harvest, we are harvesting these ponds during the first week of December, which is the peak of the dry season. So after the first harvest, the ponds will be properly prepared again, and the dikes will be equally arranged properly for further production. So we'll just walk you through down to the extreme and show you what it is. Alright, so just come along. Ando, you can get that bench out from there. Alright, so we'll move along. So you can see this is the one we just added to it to prevent the bench from having access to the fishes. All right, so we'll continue down to the end and we'll come back at some point so that we can actually carry out the feeding proper, because we can't keep you waiting while doing the feeding. So we just want to show you the whole of it. So this is the bigger one. You can see it's quite wide and massive. So we have about approximately 4,900 fishes in here. So we have this one and the extreme one there, so you can see the net over both of them as well. So it's a total of 5 fish ponds, and we've stocked successfully 13,000 plus fishes here, plus the additions that came with the stock. Unfortunately, I was supposed to make the video the day the fishes arrived, but I was actually having some activities at school, so quite unfortunate we couldn't make that video. But like I said, sooner or later, I've trained a lot of guys that are capable of making this video, so sometimes you may not see me, but some of my boys will be handling these exercises. So this is the view of the snail farm. Like we said from the first video we made here, it's a combination of snail and fish farm. So this is going to be the concrete pens. We are expecting about 336 pens from this giant structure. And if you look at the other extreme, we have 2 greenhouses that we are going to install. installation should take place in another 1 week from today. So probably when we're done with all of this construction and tidied up the environment, we'll make another video to show you the complete work on this site. So this site is located in Bay Bridge. I think it's Bansia Bay Bridge, Yenagoa local government area of Bayelsa State. So this is one of our facilities. In fact, it's the very first massive one we're doing here in Bayelsa, and it's been a huge success on the part of the fishes, and we're expecting similar from the snail reef section. So thank you. It's been a wonderful time having you guys around on this journey, and I want to say a very big thank you to all of you. And just in case you want to reach us, the number to call remains +23480685250 32. Until we hear from you, don't forget to click on the like and also subscribe to the channel and keep following us. We've got great content coming. So thank you very much. Just to give you a view of the perch that was brought out from. So this is it. You can see it has a very long beak, with which it picks a lot of fishes. So I'm not sure what we're gonna do to it right now, but definitely something has to be done. All right, so thank you. God bless you, and bye-bye.